John Salazzo's Democratic Club was honoring market, but it was toilet paper. That's what he was going to talk about or read to me. Another unique experience we had together when the hotel workers went on strike. Where am I standing? Just right back that way at the Holiday Inn. We're on the picket line, a police officer with a unique name of Castellano comes over and tells Larry, "I'm going to arrest you." Larry said, "For what?" "It's illegal to have a can of soda on the picket line." Now, I'm on CCRB day. So Larry does the right thing, Gene O'Donnell was there. Yes, for the duty captain. And the duty captain came and told the story, and the captain told him, "You can't do that, there's no law." "Well, what if it's full and he throws it at somebody?" Are they unruly? No. Is there any indication of that? No. Well, Larry told him, "I'll do you a favor, I'll give you the empty can. You can have the nickel." One Sunday morning when I lived down in Huguenot, I was awakened because a few houses away, Mike Maloney was in a hospital bed being pushed down the street by 726 members because I don't know if it was, I think it was Prendergast that was living there, and the health benefits were in jeopardy, and Larry with his street theater took that to his house and made the manager bargain decently. You all know that he had a horse carriage pulled for ITA employees at an NTA meeting to show the lack of wages for your brothers. When I met Larry, and he had just taken over as president, he inherited a Cadillac, which was not his style. And also in the back of the Cadillac, and then when he went to the Mercury, there was always in the back seat the wooden box of Bibles that he would give to 726 deceased members. And I clearly remember the Bibles being there. All of those years. Larry may not have been thought of as a religious man by the definition of attending church weekly, but he lived by the Judeo-Christian creed of help your fellow man. And not just mankind, but Larry lifted up women, minorities, gays, all that were discriminated against in the world and especially at the workplace. Larry and a couple of members came to me when I was working for the mayor that there was a problem here in the transit authority and they didn't want to let my fellow Jewish brothers off of Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Invoking the mayor's name with one phone call to the authority, the Jewish guys and gals are off now and forevermore. You guys know better than I that the authority, whether it be here or in Boston or Detroit, they just sometimes clearly don't get it. Larry never lost in a union election, including scaring off the incumbent national president and beating his hand-picked puppet. Larry loved his work. It was his prime interest in life, not baseball, not football, not any sport, but work and politics and what he could do for his members. Even after the recent gala for the 75th anniversary, a member had a legal problem, was arrested for DWI leaving the event. What I remember, he wasn't always a fan of Larry's, but that didn't stop Larry's international president jumping in and trying to help to resolve it, and Larry saved his job. As I open it, and again as I close, via Candidos, mi hermano y mi amigo, go with God, my brother and friend.